morning, my dear students. Let's continue with refraction of light. And today we will be doing refraction through a spherical surface. Okay. And there is an expression which is frequently asked in ISC question. That is the expression which relates the refractive indices of the two media, the image distance, the object distance, and the radius of curvature of the refracting surface. Okay. So let's begin with the derivation. First, we will be taking refraction from denser. So this is the denser medium of refractive index mu 2. Okay. From denser to rarer medium of refractive index mu 1. Okay. And it is at a spherical convex refracting surface. Okay. So we have taken this refracting surface. Object, point object is taken on the principal axis. The name of the object is O. Okay. The incident ray number 1 is incident here. And when we draw the normal will pass through the center of curvature of the refracting surface. Okay. And now it is moving from a denser to a rarer medium. So it will move away from the normal. So the refractive ray will be moving away from the normal. This is the angle of incidence. And this is the angle of refraction, R. Okay. Now this angle between this principal axis and the first incident ray is taken as alpha. The angle between the normal and this light is taken as gamma. And the angle between the refracted ray and this principal axis is taken as beta. Okay. And here the image will be formed because we have taken one more ray which is crossing the optical center. Okay. And as you know, the ray does not get deviated if it crosses the center of curvature. So it will just go and meet the first refracted ray at I, where the image is said to be formed. Okay. Now here, if you take the distance between the pole and the center, it is equal to R, radius of curvature. Okay. Now if you take the distance between the pole and the object, it is taken as U, that is called the object distance. Alright. And if you take the distance between this and the image location, it is taken as the image distance. Alright. So we have supposed a refracting surface of the plane XY whose pole is at P and the center of curvature is at C. Okay. Now this convex surface separates a denser medium of refractive index mu 2 from a rarer medium of refractive index mu 1. And obviously mu 2 will be greater than mu 1 because it is a denser medium. Okay. Now O is the object lying on the principal axis whose image is formed at I after refraction, which is the real image of O. Now let's apply Snell's law. Okay. Snell's law. Mu 2 by mu 1 is equal to sin R by sin I. Actually it is sin I by sin R, but here I have taken mu 2 by mu 1 because mu 2 is the first surface and mu 2 is the refracting index of the second surface. Alright, and it will be just the reciprocal. Okay, using mu 1 by mu 2 is equal to, if you just go by the conventional formula, it is sin I by sin R. That means refractive index of the second medium mu 1 divided by the refractive index of the first medium, that is mu 2, is equal to sin I divided by sin R, which I have just reversed it here. That is mu 2 by mu 1 is equal to sin R divided by sin I. Okay. Or if you just cross multiply, you will be getting mu 2 sin I is equal to mu 1 sin R. Alright, let's keep it aside because we will be using this relation later on. Now, one important thing here is that if you have small angle, that is, if the value of I and R are small, then in radian, the value of sin I will be almost equal to the angle itself, okay? And sin R will almost be equal to the angle itself, that is equal to R. So this expression can be rewritten as mu 2 into I is equal to mu 1 into R. Okay, that becomes my equation number 2. Now, we will take triangles to find out the expression for I in terms of alpha, beta and gamma. I and R in terms of alpha, beta and gamma. If you take the triangle. I just put the name A here, okay, and this is C. So if you take triangle OAC, we will use the property here that the sum of interior opposite angles is equal to the exterior angle. So if you take this triangle, which are the interior opposite angles? It is I and alpha, and the exterior is gamma. So I can write I plus alpha is equal to gamma, or because I want the relation for I is equal to gamma minus alpha. Alright. Similarly, in triangle IAC, okay, same relation, sum of interior opposite angles is equal to exterior angle. So here exterior angle is R. So R will be equal to gamma plus beta. So R is equal to gamma plus beta. This is from triangle IAC. Alright. Now, if you just replace the values of I and R in this expression, you will be getting mu 2 into gamma minus alpha is equal to mu 1 into gamma plus beta. Alright. Now, we have derived an expression connecting alpha, beta, gamma. Okay. Now, we draw a perpendicular because we need a right angle triangle now. So we will draw a perpendicular AM, okay, on the principal axis. Now, angles are small. We can use tan theta will again equal to, will be almost equal to theta, which is equal to perpendicular by base. So we will take L divided by R, okay, perpendicular by base. We get mu 2. So if you take a tan of gamma, okay, here gamma is here, okay. So if you take tan gamma, it will be perpendicular by base. So what is perpendicular for that one? It is AM divided by base is MC minus, this is tan gamma, which is almost equal to gamma. Okay, so here I am writing it here. Similarly, tan alpha or alpha, because the angle is small, it can be written as alpha. Alpha will be equal to perpendicular by base is equal to MO. Take this triangle for gamma and take this triangle for alpha. Okay, is equal to, similarly on this side also, mu 1 gamma or tan gamma is equal to AM by MC plus tan beta on that side, again it is equal to AM divided by MI. If you take this triangle, the base is MI. Alright. Now you can take AM common from both the sides, so you will be left out with mu 2 1 by MC minus 1 by MO is equal to mu 1 1 by MC plus 1 by MI. Okay, now we assume this M to be very close to P. So that means taking the aperture to be very, very small, we can say that M is very close to P. So in all this expression, we can rewrite M as P. So mu 2 is PC, PO, PC, PI. Assuming M and P are very close to each other, so they can be assumed to be merged on each other. So we have got this expression. Now applying the Cartesian sign convention, which you must be knowing, that the direction from the direction in which the ray is incident is taken as positive, the other side is taken as negative. Okay, so this PO is equal to, this PO is equal to minus U. So applying sign convention, PO is equal to minus U because it is on the opposite side in the of the direction of the ray, okay, incident ray. Then PI, it is along the direction of the incident ray. So PI or MI, it is the image distance, that is equal to plus V. Okay. And PC, that is equal to the radius of curvature, which is on this side. So it is equal to minus R. If you If you apply these in this relation, you will be getting mu 2 by minus u plus mu 1 by v, okay, is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 divided by minus r. If you just cross multiply, rearrange the terms, you will be getting this one. And finally, you will be getting mu 1 by v minus mu 2 by u is equal to mu 1 minus mu 2 divided by r. So this is the expression to be obtained, okay, for the question which is frequently asked in ISC. They ask you find the relationship between the refractive indices of the two media for a surface separating the two media. Okay, the relationship between the refractive indices, the object distance and the image distance. Alright. So mu 1 by v, that means refractive index of the second medium, no matter what it is, sometimes it may be from a rarer to denser medium. So here you put the refractive index of a denser medium divided by the image distance minus refractive index of the first medium. Here mu 2 is the first medium, divided by the object distance is equal to mu 1 minus mu 2 divided by r. Okay. So depending on the situation, we can rearrange these terms to get the formula. Now, the next one is a very important formula, that is lens maker's formula, which is a relation which connects the focal length of a lens to the radii of curvature of the two surfaces of the lens and refractive index of the material of the lens. Where is it used? It is used to design the lens of a given focal length. So you want to design a lens of a focal length which is given to you. You will use this formula, choose the radius, choose the material so that you get the desired focal length. Okay, and this is popularly known as lens maker's formula. Important, very very important. Now we take a thin lens. Okay, principal axis is here, object somewhere here, point object, okay, incident ray. Then because there is a medium, change in medium, so it will undergo refraction. Okay, now had this second surface been absent, the ray would have gone straight, so I will draw an imaginary line here. So this is the imaginary or the virtual image, okay, and but this is not absent, this is present, so it will be refracted downwards somewhere here. So you will be getting the final image here. Okay, of course the first ray is incident this side. Now this has got a center somewhere here and this has got a center somewhere here. Okay, C1 and C2. The pole of this is C1, this is C2. Okay, this is the pole of the first refracting surface and this is the pole of the second refracting surface. Okay, now let us consider a point object O lying on the principal axis of the lens. If the lens material were continuous and were no boundary, as I told you, if this was absent and there was no boundary, this would have gone straight to form an image at I dash. Okay, but because there is the presence of a second refracting surface, it will bend and form a final image as at I. Okay, now this from the pole, this is the object distance u. Okay, and since it is the final image, we take it as the final image v. Okay, and here this is v dash, where we have got an illusionary image. Okay, now using the formula mu 1 by minus u plus mu 2 by v 1. So first we will assume this is absent, so we will just take that one. Okay, V1 is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 divided by R1. It looks similar to the previous formula, but it is slightly different because the refraction is slightly different. It is occurring from a rarer to a denser medium. Okay, so the first medium is mu 1. Okay, but the lens is not continuous. Let's take it as equation 1. The lens is not continuous, therefore an image is actually formed at I. Okay, now again refraction is occurring from a denser to rarer medium. So what we do is, this, wherever this type of situation occurs, you have to keep in mind that this will be acting as the virtual object for this surface. Okay, because if you look through this surface, go to this side, you will not find any object on this side. So what we take is, what we do is take this as the virtual object whose image is formed at I. Okay, so B dash now becomes the position of the object, that is the object distance. So let's apply the formula mu 1 by v minus mu 2 by u, okay, is equal to mu 1 minus mu 2 divided by r 2. Okay, so this is v 1. Okay, now this is taken. Okay, let's rearrange it. We are applying it here, mu 1 by v, that is the final image location, minus mu 2. Now here u is the object distance for the second surface, and the object distance for the second surface is v 1. So instead of u, I write v 1 is equal to mu 1 minus mu 2 divided by R2. This is taken as equation number 2. So this formula has been modified to this formula when u is equal to v1 for the second surface. Okay, now what we do next is add equation 1 and 2. Okay, now when we add equation 1 and 2, what happens is this mu 2 by v1 gets cancelled. Okay, so after they get cancelled, we need not worry because we have just eliminated the location of the virtual object. Okay, so finally we get mu 1, 1 by v minus 1 by u is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1, 1 by r 1 minus 1 by r 2. Okay. Now after this, we can modify it, okay, we can bring this mu 1 here, okay, so finally we will get 1 by v minus 1 by u is equal to mu 2 by mu 1 minus 1, mu 1 by v 1 is 1, into 1 by r 1 minus 1 by r 2, okay. Now this mu 2 by mu 1 is the refractive index of the second medium with respect to the first one, which can be replaced by the expression, by the term mu. Okay, so this is the Lenz-Meeker's formula. Okay, but if you place the object at infinity, we can modify the formula a bit. Object at infinity means u is equal to infinity, so this can be written as 1 by object at infinity, 1 by infinity. Now you should have a concept here, that is that whenever the object is at infinity, image is formed at the principal focus. That means the image distance is equal to the focal length, so v becomes equal to f. So we can rewrite the formula as 1 by f is equal to, because 1 by infinity happens to be 0, mu minus 1, 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2, which is popularly known as the Lenz-Meeker's formula and is important from the ISE point of view also. That is all for today's class. Thank you for your attention.